Hello, my lovely friends. My name is Ava, and here are some second chance romances. This is my third recommendation video for second chance romances. I'll leave my other two down below if you want even more recommendations. So first I'm gonna talk about some contemporary romances. Then I think an alien, a paranormal, and some historical ones as well. So versus contemporary, that's the majority that I have today. So first is The Co-op by Tara DeWitt. So the hero and heroine of the story, they actually kind of like had this summer fling together when they were teenagers, but that kind of imploded in their faces. And they're also like family friends and something happened. Anyway, the relationship ended and it did not end on good terms. This book jumps years later when both of their grandparents, who actually lived together, they were like best friends, they lived together, passed away. So each grandmother actually passed down their part of this house that they shared to their respective grandchildren, and the two of them have to get married in order to like refurbish this house and sell it, you know, and they also have to live in this house together. They don't really get along though. They bicker all the time and they honestly think that they hate the other person. However, there's a fine line between love and hate, and that definitely is proven in this book. I love this one so much and I need more people to read it. It's so good. I think I read this book before I read Tara's other book that I think some more people love more than this one, but I love both equally. They're so good. And I really love like the home renovation aspect of this as well. Next I have More Than Words by Mia Sheridan. This one is about Callan and Jessica, and they met when they were children. I think Callan was living in an abandoned home, I wanna say. And Jessica ends up meeting up with him all the time. Their friendship spans years, like they're young kids, and then it grows into when they're teenagers and they're still meeting up at their same place. And they start developing like these like romantic feelings you feel when like you're a teenager, right? One day, one of them does not show up at their meeting spot ever again. This book jumps years later and actually takes place in Paris, of all places. Callan is now a famous composer and Jessica is just trying to live her life in Paris. Callan still though has some residual like trauma from his childhood and what he's experienced, and that has definitely affected him as an adult. And when he bumps into Jessica again when they're both in Paris, he realizes like, this is the only person that I've had in my entire life that has been able to keep those demons in my brain at bay. And it's his story trying to like reconnect with her and convincing her to be with him again. And it's really beautiful. Mia Sheridan knows how to write her butt off, especially with an emotional romance. There are trigger warnings in here for child abuse, alcohol abuse, ableism, depression, and childhood trauma. And there's also representation because Callan has a learning disability. Next is Love Flushed by Evie Mitchell. Our hero and heroine of the story were high school sweethearts. And I don't wanna spoil why they are not together anymore and why they actually don't really like each other, or specifically the heroine really is upset with this hero and still hasn't forgiven him for what he did to her when they were in high school, how their relationship ended. Cause I don't wanna spoil that because that is something as the reader you don't know until that point. So their relationship did not end well, did not end amicably. So this book takes place years later, they're both adults, and the heroine is trying to open up her toilet paper company. She has Crohn's disease, and she's gotta use the bathroom a lot, like tummy issue girly myself, I feel her. And there's some toilet paper out there that is not good for people who have sensitive booties because they have to wipe all the time because they're using the bathroom all the time, okay? Gotcha. So the hero of this story actually inherited recently his father's, along with his brother. So him and his brother inherited their father's paper factory company where they manufacture paper products. He doesn't really have a product to make right now, and they're gonna go out of business, and the heroine's gonna go out of business because she can't find a place to create her toilet paper for her. And so they both hear about like what the other person's going through, and they decide to team up. The heroine's not very happy about this. She's like, I do not wanna work with my ex, the man who broke my heart, but I wanna have this business going, so I'll just bite my tongue and take one for the team, essentially. So it's them reconnecting and figuring out, you're as the reader trying to figure out what happened all those years ago, why aren't they together anymore? The hero is still pining after her, but isn't going after it. And we're trying to figure out why. Next, I have Landon and Shay by Brittany Cherry, specifically part 2. Landon and Shay part 1 is the book about them falling in love as teenagers. So you get the whole story of how they first fell in love with each other. And then part two jumps years later, and that is their second chance romance. So the duet as a whole, you need to read together, because if you read part two without reading part one, you'll be so lost. But specifically part two, book number two, is the one where it's a second chance romance. But Landon and Shay end up falling for each other in high school, but very reluctantly. They don't really get along. They kind of like have the same friend group, but their friends know like these two don't get along. They're kind of like enemies, if you will. And the heroine overhears the hero making a bet with a guy at a party and is like, I bet I can make like Shay fall in love with me by the end of the summer, whatever. Like, and Shay's like, okay, not gonna happen, but I'll bet you I can make you fall in love with me first. And so it's the two of them kind of like betting to see who can make the other person fall in love first, but then they fall in love instead. And it's really beautiful. That's part one. And then part two jumps years later. I don't want to spoil that because you got to read part one first, right? But part two is their second chance romance when they're adults, and it's beautiful. I have two novellas to recommend as well that are really, really, really good. So first is Coming Home by Kennedy Ryan. This one is an Audible like original, so you can only listen to this on Audible. So Tore and Naomi went to the same college together, Finley College. They were very close friends and they always had these feelings for each other, but right on the edge of them like becoming more, I think they ended up graduating and like going off and having their own careers. And this book, little novella, takes place years later when they're both back, I think for a reunion, I wanna say, at the college. When they see each other again, they're like, ooh, I remember how awesome being with you was. So it's like just their short, sweet second chance romance. I really enjoy this one. I think this was my first and only so far Kennedy Ryan, and I can't wait to read more. Another fairly short one is Cupid's Peak by Lee Jacquo. This one's kind of second chance because they weren't actually in a relationship together or weren't together, but Mia and Eli were like friends in high school. Mia was Eli's tutor and they were both like hardcore crushing on each other in high school, but they never like took that step to become more, but they like were crushing on each other. It's 10 years later and the two of them actually get set up on a blind date together on Valentine's Day. So this is definitely one you should pick up fairly soon. It being the month of love, if you will. So, but this is a great book to read around Valentine's Day or any time in general, but it was so fun. Like it's hot. If you want a hot novella to read, like please pick this one up. And a lead romance that I have that I absolutely loved last year is Broken by the Horde King by Zoe Draven. This is another one though where the characters weren't actually in a relationship when they were younger. They kind of were, kind of weren't. There were feelings there. Anyway, so our heroine is a human woman on this planet that is native to like aliens. Aliens that the hero is from, the Jakar people. They basically look like humans except they have like different colored eyes and they have like gold skin, but they're basically the same. Like look wise, they act like the Dothraki from Game of Thrones. Okay. So the heroine of the story is a human woman though, and there are human settlements on this planet, but one day when one of the men from this village, this alien village, is patrolling the woods, they end up across the heroine like abandoned, and they end up adopting her into their family. So she's the only human in a village full of aliens, right? And she grows up kind of being bullied by the other kids in the village because she's the only human, but she befriends our hero, who's essentially kind of like the next ruler of the village, if you will, kind of like the prince. And the two become fast friends. They do everything together. And it's really beautiful seeing their friendship grow into more. Also, I love that in this book, but there comes a point when both of these characters are of age and the heroine kind of tells her feelings to the hero in front of their whole village and he rejects her in front of everybody. And she is heartbroken. There's some other things that happen as well to make her even more upset with this hero. But this book takes place years later after all of her heartbreak and the hero comes back to the village, hasn't seen her in quite a few years, and is going to grovel his butt off to convince her to come back to his new village with him. That's all I want to say. I love this one so much. Even though the two of them had feelings when they were younger, they weren't like together. So I don't know if this would be like considered second chance, but in my mind it is. I have a unique one next. This one is so unique to me. So this is Gaslight Hades by Grace Draven. This is like a kind of like steampunk book. Like it takes place in kind of like a historical setting, but there's like those steampunk aspects to it. I don't really know how to describe it. It's really cool. It's interesting though. I don't think I've read any other steampunk books, but anyway, so our heroine of the story, she is going through a lot. Her fiance passed away a few years ago. She goes to his grave quite often to pay her condolences. Then one day she comes across a ghost who is protecting her in this graveyard. And that man may or may not be, the ghost may or may not be her long lost fiance. And it's her romance with this ghost. So it's really fun. I really enjoy this one. Definitely unique. If you want a unique read, please pick this one up. Lastly, I have two historicals. So first is The Duke's Perfect Wife by Jennifer Ashley. This is book number 4 in the Mackenzies and McBride series. This is about Hart and Eleanor. Hart is actually the eldest brother in his family. And years ago, he was actually engaged to Eleanor. But for some reason, you figure out when you read the book, they broke off their engagement and they haven't seen each other in years. Then one day, Eleanor gets an anonymous letter. And in that letter, there is a nude photograph of Hart. She then tracks down Hart and asks him to help her figure out who has these pictures of him, because she doesn't want them to get out into the ton and to like ruin his life. And so it's about the two of them trying to figure out who has all these pictures of Hart. And the two of them obviously reconnect and realize that they never stopped loving each other. I really enjoy this series. I think this is the last book that I've read, and I think there's like 12 books in this series, so I definitely need to continue. And let me know what your favorite book of the series is. Number 1 so far is my favorite, because Ian is everything. And the last book that I would love to mention today is The Seduction of a Viscount Vice by Nicola Davidson. If you want hot historical romances, like Nicola Davidson is your ticket, honey. This is the romance between Ian and Mari. In this series, this is the third book in the series. It's about these three men who own this pleasure club. Okay, and the hero of this book actually performs for people in the pleasure club. One night he apprehends a footman that's in the club and thinks that it's a spy, and he finds out it's actually Lady Mari, the woman who broke his heart years ago. She was kind of spying on Ian's pleasure club because she's been dreaming of opening her own. And there are some things going on when she figures out that Ian is the owner of the rivaling pleasure club to hers, the man that she abandoned, she did not want to abandon, was forced to abandon years ago. She is having some second thoughts. I really enjoy this one. If you want hot, hot, hot historical books, you gotta pick this one up. Anyways, there you have it. Those are some second chance romances. Let me know down below if you've read any of these books or if you plan to. But if you don't feel like commenting any of those things, you can leave me a ghost emoji in the comment section down below. But anyways, thank you all so much for watching. I will see y'all soon in my next one. Bye, y'all.